the Lord present, just invade your spirit and your soul, your body. Y'all feel that? That's why you don't want no negative energy around you. No negative karma around you. No. Only allow the spirit of positivity. Can I say it like that? Yeah. To hang around you. because of the, you know, because that's what's gonna birth. Ooh, I like that. That's what's gonna birth in your life. 2022 is almost over. Now we're getting ready to cross over into the 2023. And guess what? The same God that brought you over, and even before you were born.
That's right.
That's the same God gonna keep bringing you over and over from level to level and faith to faith. It will never stop as long as you stay with Him. Whoa, the man good to us, you all. Come on, let's get up on the car. We're gonna pray. We're gonna release the prophetic word of the living God in your life, because the word of the living God is so true and so faithful that God has honored His word above any, ever, and all word. It's His word that we should applaud and praise and honor and give Him the glory, because it's His word. I like that. The Bible would say that it's the highest law, not only in the heaven, but it's in the earth, in hell. It doesn't matter. God is still God, and I'm so excited because of the fact He is God. And guess what else? Babies, prepare yourself, because of the fact you're going to be the person that's going to carry what you call good news.
Come on.
Good news, Cookie. Good news, Terry. You should be saying, I'm going to be the barrier of good news. No negativity, no none of that. No negative energy, no negative, none of that stuff. Yeah. Only positivity. You know, am I saying that right?
Yeah.
Positivity. That positivity that you want to be hanging around you. And you're going to get on one accord, and you're going to see the glory. I'm telling you, I have just been so blessed by seeing, not just by hearing, but seeing the power of God move on your behalf and people behalf and on my behalf, and it's just so good. Hey everybody, good afternoon. This is the Wednesday, and you know what the Lord said to me? He said, listen up, we're no longer just the ministry of love. Ooh, I like that. Terry, you heard that?
That's good. Yes, we're no longer.
He said that you're no longer just the ministry of love. He said, we are the new ministry of love. You see, you catch people that changing names and changing names and changing names. No, God always gives you ministry according to the characteristic. I should have said to the character of who you are. Am I right about that? He always gives you ministry to the character of whom that person is. If you're a person of faith, he'll give you faith ministry. If you're a person of love, he'll give you love ministry. But you know what, don't. You got to understand that it's got to be all God or no God at all. Because of the fact God is not going to undermine His word, nor would He let His word fall, nor would He let His word not accomplish. Yeah, not accomplish of what He said that He has already done. Hey, love, I love you so much. Stop, like, and share, because this is your day, and God has something to say to you out there in this prayer time. That we come together on Monday, Wednesday, and Friday, and we come together as one, and we pray. And the Bible says that when you get on one accord and begin to pray to the same God, my Bible tell me on the day of Pentecost, hell got shook up. Because you know why? Because the devil knew we became a threat to him. He knew it was over for him. The devil knew that it was over for him, T. So therefore, you're a threat to your enemy. You can expect, you know, to fight, but you got to understand that you fight the good fight of faith. You know, you can expect, you know, glory to God. If God give you a word, it's going to be challenged. If He give you a word, it's going to be challenged. So you got to expect to know that God has honored everything that He has spoken in your life. Now keep in mind and remember, whatever you release from your heart, the Bible says, from the abundance of your heart, your mouth speak it. So therefore, whatever you want to live around you, that's what you got to speak. Because of the fact is what I believe, remember? They give power to anything. I'm so excited that I'm one of the most wealthiest women that ever lived on this earth. Do I hear you? Do I hear you out there? You should be saying, I'm excited because I'm one of the most wealthiest men you ever laid your eyes on. I'm one of the most wealthiest women, say it, that you ever laid your eyes on. Why? Because the Lord God that I serve can't lie, can't die, and sure enough, can't fail. Guess what? Track record too good. Now, you know what? When I get this happy, I don't have to do my own stuff. I'd be like,
off the flag.
Hold me, Jesus. Hold me, Jesus. Hold me, Jesus. He loves himself. So you come, let's go in prayer. Father, in the name of Jesus, we bring all glory to your name. We bring all praise to your name. We bring all honor to your name. We call upon the name of the Lord thy God. Just a little bit for the baby. We just call upon the name of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. We call upon the Father. Let me tell you something. As we come together, you don't have to turn up. You just Lord. Let me tell you something. Come together on one accord. There is power in agreement. There's power in agreement. Come together on one accord and let us all agree with what the word of the living God is saying to you right now. And the Lord is speaking out of the abundance of the heart. The mouth is going to speak. There's so many good things going on for you right now.
You.
Your 2023 is not going. Oh my God. It will not look like your 2022. And that's for white, black, rich, poor. I don't care who you are. I don't care what your nationality is. I don't care, me and God. The word is for everybody that God means what he says. And that's why I say, let us all come together and reason. I like that. And talk to our Father. And let him get the last word. And let him lead. Let him guide. Let him direct. Let him instruct. And let him order your little footsteps. There's no coincidence that you're on this page at this very second. Because the fact is called a moment. And see, once that moment happened, you may not get that moment back until way whatever. But this is the moment now that God is moving. And God is saying great wealth, great health, and great success. I dare you to believe it. Great wealth, great health, and great success. You see, when you release your faith in the word of the living God, you begin to activate the promises of what my Father has promised you. You got to receive it. Nobody could do it for you but you. You receive it in the name of the Father. Come on. You receive it in the name of the Son and the Holy Spirit. As we pray. I'm just so happy. Dear Father, I love you. God the Father, God the Son, God the Holy Spirit. Father of Abraham, Father of Isaac, Father of Jacob. We come in the name of Jesus. We come lifting your name. We come bowing down, oh God, at your feet in your presence. We come saying to you, Father, if we have fallen short in any form or fashion, known or unknown, we ask for your forgiveness right now and just now. But Lord, we want you, Father, take out what don't belong in us and leave us with your word. Oh, because the word of God is the will of God, the mind of God, and the very representation of who God really is. My God is a conqueror. My God is a deliverer. I'm talking to somebody. Yes, I am. My God is a healer. My God is a bless maker. I like that. You see, all these things that you've been calling blessings, they're just the effect of the blessings. Because of the fact those blessings never, 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 never stop. As long as you stay with my Father, you already all right. I hear the Holy Spirit. So receive it. Receive great wealth. Receive it. Receive great health. Receive it. Receive great success. Receive it. Receive it in the name of the Father. Receive it in the name of the Son and the Holy Spirit. And I thank God in advance that no weapon formed against you will ever prosper. Not a devil in hell will ever prevail against the power of the Almighty God that rests on the inside of Bridget. Call your own name out. Because God, he only not have your back. He have your heart. God have your heart. You don't have nothing to worry about. Because he going to make sure, baby, everything work out in your favor. And everything going to turn out and going to work out for your good. Are you here to spirit of the living God? That's what he wants you to know on this Wednesday morning. He's listening up. I got you. I got you. Get happy along with me. Rejoice in the things of the Lord. Rejoice. Come on. Glorify his name. Praise him. Because he deals only with the spirit. I'm trying to say, Lord, please help me stand in this chair because I'm about to explode right now, Jesus, with the love of God and joy. Woo! Let me tell you. It's that, you see, whomever you feed the most, that's the one that's going to dominate. And you see, when you feed your spirit the most, your spirit dominates. God have you balanced. Because of the fact there's another world besides this world. This world is called the natural world. Then you have the spiritual world. So you're living between two worlds right here. But God is preparing you through by the word of the living God how to function, how to operate, and how to live betwixt the two. But you're always a conqueror. Because the Lord has defeated your enemy. You have nothing to fear. Listen up. That's what I tell you all the time. I'm going to tell you over and over again. I just want you to release your faith. Release your faith in the word. Release your faith in the word. Release your faith in the word. Now, 2023, that's going to be a year that you're going to live off of your surplus. That's going to be the year that you're not going to miss. You're not going to miss it. You're going to give it, but you won't miss it because it's going to be so much. This is why the Lord have me saying to you today. You make sure you seek out what you call a manager. You make sure you seek out in what you call financially, advisor. Because of the fact you want to know. Because it's so much. It's pounding on my heart. It's so much. And when God speak, it's a done deal already. It's nothing you can do about it. But just receive it or reject it. It's on you now. Whether how bad you want it. But I want you to take a moment. Deuteronomy, watch this now. Deuteronomy 1 and 11. Have you heard of a 1,000-fold increase? Mm-hmm. That's more than enough. That's the abundance. That's the superseding your imagination.
Yeah.
That's gone beyond what I can act. That's beyond what I can think. That's beyond what I can say. That's beyond that. Why? Because of the fact God declared. He told Moses, you let them know. I've already blessed them. 1,000-fold increase. That means before the seed is planted in the ground good, the harvest coming up. Oh, God know your heart. He know your heart, babies. God is not concerned about, you know, these foolish thoughts. He know your heart, Tara.
That's right, he does.
Receive with the Holy Spirit. Receive the 1,000-fold increase, Ryan. Receive it in the name of the Father. Receive the abundance. Receive the more than enough. Receive everybody. Receive the glory of the Lord. Receive the healing of the Lord. Receive the wisdom of the Lord. Receive the divine revelation knowledge of the Lord. Receive the wisdom beyond your age. Receive the sight that's beyond your sight. Receive it in the name of the Father. Receive it in the name of the Son. Receive it in the name of the Holy Spirit. Receive it in the name of the Lord Jesus. Because God has done some great and mighty things. I'm telling you, he did a lot of stuff from a lot of people. But to you, he said, I will not hide it from you. Because the fact is, the truth is, you belong to God. Now, if you take your time and write these scriptures down. Now, the Bible says this. Now, you just saw, write it down now. In Deuteronomy 1st chapter, 11th verse, he talked about the 1,000-fold increase. You better get it. You better get in on it because of what God has done. You don't want to miss it. You do not want to miss it. What God has done. Hey, my sweetheart. Hey, my Steve. Hey, my Takara. Hey, everybody. Just hello to everybody. God love himself, some you. That's why he said rejoice. Rejoice in hope. Rejoice. Why should I rejoice? Because of the fact the word, the living God, just planted in your heart. It's like it's anchored in the Lord. Ooh, ooh. You know those big old ships? How you anchor those big old ships? Mm-hmm. And they can't be moved. Mm-hmm. But that's what God is saying. He said, listen up. The word that I spoke in your life, in your heart. He said, the word is sealed by the blood of Jesus. What could come through the blood? Nothing, my sweetheart.
Nothing
can come through the blood. Are you hearing the Holy Spirit? That's for God wants you to have just that much. Receive it. I'm here today to deliver it to you. God said these words. And listen up. He said, listen, it's no longer a ministry of love. It's the new ministry of love.
Come on.
God got some up his sleeve. God got some on his mind concerning you.
Yes.
Because he always give the increase. He never do decrease. He always give the increase. Are you in the Holy Spirit? That's why he give every man a measure of faith. It's like go all the way up to the, it's like to the 100th floor elevator. It's way, way up there. But the thing is that if your faith level is not there, then bring your little self back down to 10, the 10th floor. And wherever you are, that's where God is going to meet you. And he's going to bless you right where you are. But I love it. Thousandfold increase. And on top of that, he says, watch now. In 3 John, I believe it. Let me make sure I have it straight. And 3 John, I believe it's 3 John 1 and 2. Beloved. Look how God loving you. Look how God saying, beloved. Look how God calling you his little sweetheart. Look how God is saying, you're so special. Look how God is saying, you're so chosen. Look how God is saying, you're so unique. Look how God is saying, you're so different. Look how God is saying, you're not ordinary. Look how God is saying you're extraordinary. Look how God, just pay attention. Look how God sees you. This is how he sees you. Beloved, I wish you that thou would prosper. Great health, great wealth, and great success. That means everything I put my hand on. I'm going to tell you something over and over again. 2023, that's the year of the surplus. And it's going to take you to tap in on it and believe. And take him at his word. It's going to be on you. Because he has done his part. Now it's up to you to do your part. Receive it. Lord, my inner man is like rolling. Like it's rolling on the inside because of the glory of the Lord. The praise of the Lord. And the truth of my Father. My Bible says he bear witness to nothing but the truth. My Bible says that when Mary and Elizabeth. When they connected together, the baby leaked in her womb. Why? Because the presence of truth was in her presence.
Yeah.
Oh my God.
Wow.
God is gonna do some wild things in 2023. When I say wild, you're very like, wow. Good wow. That's why you're saying, I am the barrier of good news.
Yes.
Nothing but good news. Why? And how? Because you're going to reap what you sow. You know you've been sowing good seeds, right? Yes, you have. Well, expect goodness to come back. It's coming to you, baby. And it's coming back not in a hundredfold, not in a 20-fold, not in a 50-fold. It's coming back to you in a thousandfold increase. It's going to run you over. All you got to do is to believe. What the Lord is saying unto you. And I heard God say this here in Psalms 128. Here it goes right here. Here it goes. Here it goes right here. Psalms 128. I believe verses 2. Hear this wisdom. He said, I bless the fruit of your labor, the work of your hands. Let me hear you say it. God has blessed the work of my hands and the fruit of my labor. I want to hear you say it again. God has blessed. The work of my hands and the fruit of my labor. See, it's your hands. It's called creative ideas. God is going to give you creative ideas. Oh, but it's going to put your hands involved. Oh, yeah. Your hands going to be involved. Your hands is going to be the one that be on that computer. And your hands are going to be the one that go forward and seek and look and find. You're not going to seek in vain. You're going to find what God has already given you. This is why the Lord is saying 2023 is your year of great success. Say surplus.
Surplus.
You know surplus is? Baby, you're going to be able to bless and not miss it. Give it and not miss it.
Thank you.
That's what the Lord is saying to you right now. You won't even be able to miss it. It's going to be so much. But he's going to give you just what he assigned to you. To manage. understand the teaching that God has been teaching through all of Sunday. How Adam, God, he was just as God. Woo! He was just as God.
Yes.
Plentiful. He never got tired. He didn't even realize, baby, he was just as God.
Come on.
He managed. This man did not manage a garden. This man managed a universe.
Yes.
Oh my God. And he never got tired. Because he was operating off the supernatural strength of the Almighty God. But when he failed, then God immobilized some things. And he wouldn't allow him to tap in on that anymore. And that's why he told the angels, guard the tree of knowledge. Mm-hmm. Because of the fact he didn't want him to get a hold of those things.
That's right.
Oh, yeah, baby. Oh, yeah. Mm-mm. God said, no. No. He had to immobilize some things. But you still could have walked and talked with God. But yeah, what would I love it? Give me this wisdom right here. He said it. He said in Psalms 128, I will bless the work of your hands. I will bless the works of your hand. You do hair? I will bless the work of your hand. You do cars? I will bless the work of your hands. You model? I will bless the work of your hands. The work of your hands is the creativity of God, of what he has given you that he haven't given to anybody else. Now, this is the key. You're going to have to learn to be quiet. And you're going to have to learn to stop trying to convince people. Persuade, that's not for them. It's not you. They are not on your level to receive that. So therefore, they do not understand that. You really don't want to say it. Baby, before time, because of the fact it'd be premature. Why you say that, Pastor Star? See, people have a tendency of stealing vision. They don't just steal money. They steal visions. They steal dreams. Because of the fact they listen at you. So therefore, until you got that thing copyrighted, until you got that thing LLC, until you got that thing on lockdown, shut your mouth. Whoa! Because God intended for nobody to steal what he gave you. And he means what he says. And he says what he means.
Right.
It's going to be such a glorious time for you. And it's like an explosion. It's going to explode your little mind. Because of the fact the word said, do exceedingly above and abundant more than you can ask or think. If you can see it, you can have it. That's why he told the children of Israel. Moses said, look, boys, go out and check it out. Check it out for me, boys. And they did. But they let fear got in their way. Fear would kill it every time. It would kill the dream. It would kill the vision. You know what? We're going to curse the spirit of fear. We're going to denounce the spirit of fear. We're going to rebuke the spirit of fear. But we're going to lose the power of the Almighty God. We're going to lose the power of God's favor. We're going to lose the power of God's grace.
Yes.
We're going to lose the power of God's wealth. We're going to lose the power of God's divine revelation.
Mm-hmm.
We're going to lose the power of wisdom beyond your age. We're going to lose the power of the Almighty God to hedge around you. Because as he hedged around you, that means nothing could get in except he allowed it to be so. And if God allowed things to be, say it. See it through the eyes of the Spirit.
That's right.
See the good in it.
That's right.
See the good in it. Because what's going on, Pastor Star? It's going to work out in your favor. It's going to work out for your good. I don't care what it look like. I don't care about folks report. I don't care about what this and that and the other. You shouldn't either. Because God got your blessings, baby, on lockdown just for you. And when you release your faith, the key going to open it up. What? What you mean, Pastor Star? Your faith is the key, baby. It's going to open everything up that God promised you. Under the blood, under the oath, in the name of the Father, in the name of the Son, in the name of the Holy Spirit, not one word will fall to the ground. This is why I have to contain myself, because I can get so happy and I can just run and leave you all just like, what she wearing? She's not finished. She's not finished talking. Wow. God got something to say. Yes, he does. And he's speaking to you right now. He's speaking his blessings in your life right now. He's speaking that conquering blood right now. He's speaking right now great charm right now. He's speaking number favor right now. He speaks it because it's what you believe that give power to anything. Your faith, are you hearing the spirit of the living God? That's why you want to increase their faith. That's why it's good. It's no. It is not, no. If you are a believer, no. You don't say, God, give me more faith. No, you have faith. You want to say, Lord, protect my faith. Whoa, protect my faith, Lord. He told Peter, the devil sniffed you as weak, Peter. He wants your faith because he knows, baby, the faith that God has put in you is going to take you beyond measure of what you even attempt to think about, attempt to do something about it, attempt. He already sees the heart. See, my Bible tells me that God judges the heart. He sees the mind, but he judges the heart. It's from the heart that the Lord is looking at you right now. And if you receive it and believe it, then it is so. Because God has done it for you. It's 30 minutes already?
Yes, ma'am. Almost 35.
Y'all know what? Now, this don't make no sense.
It's good.
It don't make no sense.
Mm-hmm.
Because of the fact what God has said, he has said it. Now, to me, it was like 5 minutes. Oh, my God. But you gotta catch it. You gotta catch it. You gotta catch it. God is gonna give you creative ideas. God is gonna give you God ideas. They're gonna work. They are gonna work. They are gonna work. They are gonna work. Because he put them in you so that it may multiply. And it will multiply where your mind won't even understand it. You're in that moment right now. You're in that season of it right now. That God is multiplying. Oh my God. He's multiplying. You might be saying, I'm not where I should be. Stop it. Stop it. Because in fact, that's the trick of the enemy. God said, listen up. 1,000 years is like one day to God.
Yes.
God is never behind time. But he's always on time.
Oh.
You run with this here. You run with it and you tell the Lord, thank you. Tell the Lord, I want you to begin to tell God every day, Lord, protect my faith. Lord, protect my faith. And then I want you to say, Lord, I declare and I decree in the name of the Father, in the name of the Son, and in the name of the Holy Spirit, I decree Psalms 23, I decree Psalms 91 to rest over my life, to rest over my family, to rest over the ministry. To rest or whatever it may be. And a turnaround going in. Because if God has honored the prayers that you prayed. Because you have prayed nothing but his word. God loved you so much. It's something that man can't even fathom. You can't even fathom this with your mind. Because it's so much. But you keep this in your heart. And you keep it in your mind. Natural resources. It's going to hit your house, Philip. What you mean natural resources? Because of the fact God made you spirit, soul, body, right? Mm-hmm. So God knows that the soul relates to the natural, right? And he knows that the body only can deal with the natural, right?
That's right.
Ooh! But God said, I just want you to be balanced with everything.
Yeah.
Are you hearing the Holy Spirit? I want you to be balanced with everything. He knows that you need natural resources to survive. Natural resource, the food you need to eat, that's to survive. The clothes you need to wear, that's to survive.
That's right.
The wealth that you, see all that money about to come to you? You see all that money about to come to you? That's what you call natural resource for natural living. That God is going to outpour in your life, upon you, in your children. Your business is going to explode. Everything where your name rests is going to explode. Your past, that's gone already. God don't want to deal with that. He says, I'm dealing with it right now. He's dealing with it right now. The right now. I'm so wealthy, I smell like wealth. You better talk like God wants you to talk. You're so wealthy, you smell like wealth. And when you go outside, you look like wealth. And they're going to speak it all on you. They ain't got nothing but money. And you're going to be like, sure do, baby. Keep speaking it. Because you know what? You just happen to come up. You just happen to come along the way. A little bit faster. A little bit faster. And a little bit faster. And a little bit faster. God love you. I'm a Takara, I love you. Your labor is not in vain. Anything you do to glorify my Father is never in vain. God got you. God got you. God got you. God got you. Take him in his word, please. Take him in his word. I got to get off on this line, but take God at his word. But I'm going to give you this before I leave. You got scriptures to go out. You got Deuteronomy, the first chapter, 11 verse. You have 3 John 1 and 2. You have Psalms 128 verses 2. You have that. And God said, oh, but this is what I love. He said, blessings of those who fear the Lord. Yes. Woo! Blessings. This is in the Bible. I didn't write this. Blessings of those who fear the Lord. Yes. You will eat the fruit of your labor and the works of your hand. Because God is giving you creative ideas. Get up. And if you feel like that, oh Lord, no. Hear wisdom. Lord, you're giving me this, but I feel drained. I feel tired. Mm-hmm. This is what you tell God. Will me, Father.
Yeah, thank you, Lord.
Will me with the strength to do it. Will me with the wisdom to do it. Send co-labors across my path. Allow, you told me from your own mouth, you was going to send you to you. Let me use myself. He said like this, Bridget, I'm going to send you to you. So if you've been doing things evilly, conniving, and manipulative, that's what's coming to you. But if you've been doing things authentic, genuine, from your heart, is real, love for real, everything you're doing is real from your heart. Baby, that's what, Lord have mercy, that's what's coming back. That's what's coming to you.
Thank you, Jesus.
That's what's coming to you. That's what's coming to you. Get up and receive it. Before the year, you know what? My birthday is all this month, and you all gonna help celebrate my birthday too.
When is it?
Is it December 28th?
No, but I thought I heard you say all this
all
month.
This month. Oh yeah, all this month. That's right. You gonna celebrate me at Jesus?
All this what? Month.
How old you gonna be, Pastor Style? You gotta worry about all that. I'm 25. You know I heard Prince. You know Prince. He passed and gone to glory, right? And he said, they said, how old are you? He said, well, I put it to you like this. He said, I was only born one time. He said, and that was my birthday.
I
got that from Prince. I did. And then he took his shades out like this here. He did this. I promise to God he did. And then he said, and look down. That means that that's why I look 10 years younger.
Yeah.
Because of the fact I do not allow you to put an age on me.
That's right.
He said, because I was only born one time. That's when they call it my birthday. Oh, Oh, my God. Birthday. Well, so what I'm going to do, every day is my birthday right now. December. All this month. You make sure you go to that Cash App and you say, Pastor Stein, you've been such a blessing to so many people. We want to bless you, Pastor Stein.
That's right. See,
I'm so happy that God has given me back where I was, to where I love showing up blessing people with vehicles.
Yes.
I love showing up blessing people with just blessing, just bless. I love that. That just do something to my. It just does something to my adrenaline inside. It's like, oh Lord, I'm getting ready to bless. Get ready to bless somebody. Just pump me up. Don't just say, I'll be pumped up. I'll be pumped up. Like, whoo, get ready to bless somebody. That make me feel so good. And that's why God said, you will live off your surplus in 2023. you will live the thousandfold increase. That means that's more than enough.
Yes.
I love you. Come on, let's receive the word. Father, in the name of Jesus Christ, I come right now as my heart is full right now, Father. But I come in your name. You know, Jesus said it like this to the disciples. While I'm with you, boys, you don't have to say nothing to the Father. The word is already in your midst. I got everything that you need. You need bread? Tell him to sit down. I'm going to multiply. You need fish? Tell him to sit down. I'm going to multiply. What you need? He said, I got it already. He said, all you got to do is just believe me for it. Are you hearing the Holy Spirit? He said, but boys, let me tell you something, boys. When I go back home to my Father, this is what I want you to do, and this is the way I want you to pray. Ask my Father anything in my name. My Father going to do it.
Amen.
My Father going to do it. I got to hold it down, girl. I promise. I get so excited until... Oh, yes, 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 yes. Savannah Grace. Savannah Grace. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday, Savannah. Happy birthday to you. That's my mom, baby. Savannah. Oh, she's so sweet, 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 sweet. So, Savannah, you and I, it's our birthday, girl. Oh, yes, we are. It's our birthday. But we ain't telling our age. You know what I'm saying? Because we're going to just keep getting younger and younger. But this is what you're going to do, baby. This is what you're going to do. Young, young, young. Watch, 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 watch. Now I'm going to let you go home. I'm going to let you go home. Watch this here. Paul said it like this in 2 Thessalonians 2 and 12. You got to get it. 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 Paul said it in 2 Thessalonians 2 and 13. I want to do 2 and 12 first. 2 and 12 say that they all may be damned who believe not the truth. What? What? Because you don't believe what God is saying. You damn your, you damn your own self. That means you curse your own self. Whoa. And then, I love it. Watch, 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 watch. I did so much. I can tell you. Look at this here. And then he said this here. I love it, I love it, love it. He said these words here. He said in Thessalonians 2 and 13, he said, but as it is the truth, the word of God, which effectually worketh also in you that believe. Don't you curse. Stop cursing yourself. By speaking wrong things out of your mouth and hanging around wrong people. That negativity stuff will come and lean on. No, 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 babe. Lean back. Lean back. Don't come to me. Stay. You 50 feet away. 150 feet away from me. Don't come right here because ain't nothing coming to you but blessings, and that's what's coming to you. Blessing, not my blessing. But I love this here. Let's go. I love it. I'll never have enough time to finish. Never. Look at this here. Man, just whatever. Look at this here. He said in Hebrews 3 and 12, take heed, my brother. He said, lest there be any of you an evil heart, unbelief. You mean to tell me that God, you doing all that speaking in tongues, and not believing nothing God telling you?
Wow.
And God will put you in the category of evil.
Wow.
Because of the fact you're doing all that. And don't believe nothing you say.
Just making noise.
Just making all that noise. You better stop all that foolishness. But look at this here. Look at this. I got to give it to you. I got to give it to you. Then I'm going to let you go. Then I'm going to let you go. Then I'm going to let you go. Share this. Share with someone else. Make sure you listen. When you bless the prophet, you know you get a prophet reward, right?
Mm-hmm.
What you believe in God for. It's gonna happen just like he said. But you got to hear this shit for your heart. Let's go. Let's go. Time fast. I'm so fast, man. That just trust me. Oh, how time fast. Time be just flying by. But this will bless me right here.
Uh-huh.
I love it. Last scripture for today. 1 Corinthians 2 and 5. Get your pad and pencil and make sure you write them down. 1 Corinthians 2 and 5. That your faith should not stand in the wisdom of men. Whoa, look at this here. But in the power of the Almighty God. Your faith in God? God don't need no man to validate nothing when it comes to bridging. My faith, boo. Let me shout. Let me shout. God don't need nobody else but you.
For you to believe. For you to receive.
I love it. I gotta go. I gotta go. Crookie, you know what? That's the song, you know, that Fred Hammond be singing. Man, oh, Cookie, I love it. Because you know, I love to dance. Oh, me and Jesus. And then you're so balanced. Yes. Come on, let's dance. Tell me about it. Yeah. You see, because of the fact, let me tell you, Lord, this is what blessed me. With God, Grace TBN to publish this book. Gotta have your copy. Don't just get you one. Get one for everybody. Because God wants you free. He wants you so free. He don't want you walking out. Hide. I got to hide this. They go past them. Do something to me. It irks my nerves. Because I ain't got to please nobody but my chief. Oh, my God. This is what we're going to go off with. Can you put it on Cookie? Cookie, I'm so excited. I be waiting to get here. Cookie, I be waiting to get here. If I could tell you all the things that God is doing right now, you'd be like, what? Oh, yeah. Start it up. And turn it up. There you go. Now, say good. I love you. Sign off time.
Get mad.
Sign up anytime you want to. Walk out with your blessing.
on today. I got